to this message will be blessed, and their eyes will be opened to see the truth and the light.
Inmate number 109031 at Riverbend Security Prison, Don Johnson of Covington. He awaits the electric chair with his tape recorder and his Bible.
Watch over us. Help us to know that.
Johnson records a gospel radio show in his cell on death row. He tells his listeners he is not afraid to die.
Death is just a sleep. When I wake is when Christ returns and takes me home, takes me to heaven.
Johnson was convicted in 1984 of brutally murdering his wife, Connie. He stuffed a plastic bag down her throat and choked her, and later dumped the body at a Memphis shopping mall.
We're all classified as one here, regardless of who did what.
Today, Johnson fights for his own life and the lives of all death row inmates.
One life, can you put a value on one life taken wrongly, no matter who takes it? And you compound that when the state takes it wrongly.
The last execution in Tennessee was here at the old state prison in Nashville, commonly called the Walls. On November 7, 1960, William Tynes of Memphis was sent to the electric chair for the rape of a young woman.
Since that day, the Death Watch chambers have been empty. A Tennessee death row inmate can wage as many as 12 court battles before being put to death.
The state will pay for...
UT Professor Neil Cohen is an expert on constitutional law and says time may be running out for some prisoners.
It's very likely that within the next couple of years there will be an execution in Tennessee, and there are a number of people on death row who are getting close to finishing their final court battles.
Lord, we ask for the forgiveness of our sins and our transgressions, Lord. Lord, we give all the praise and glory to you. In Jesus' name I pray, Lord. Amen.